William Shakespeare said, "One touch of nature makes the whole world kin." There's a peace in God's creation that transcends all understanding, makes brothers of strangers, and connects us to our ancestors. I first learned of Rick Carone and a unique challenge he faces daily through a mutual friend, Cameron Haynes. Cam made a mission of helping and supporting Rick by introducing him to his massive outdoors-loving following. The love, prayers, and support Rick has received through Cam's support has been nothing short of miraculous. It has also been a tremendous source of strength.
It was one of those days where, you're in the hospital for something that you think's just maybe a minor allergic reaction. I woke up from some testing and said that I had pancreatic cancer. I was devastated. I was scared to death. I didn't know how to react. I didn't know what to think. And having two daughters in their teenage years, you don't ever want to tell them anything bad or what's happening to dad. And a way to protect them, but I also have to be real with them. We found out 3 days later it was stage four, that it had spread to my liver and one of my kidneys, and so that means that it is inoperable. You can either choose to hit it head on, or you can choose to just lay down and let it overtake you. And I talked with my family and close friends, and I said, hey, we're gonna do this, we're gonna beat it, we're gonna fight like hell, and I'm gonna need you guys to pick me up when I can't fight. The first few treatments, I was partially blinded, paralyzed, couldn't see, for minutes, you don't know, a minute seems like a long time when things like that hit you and you go through full body cramps, and scary as heck. I'm a firm believer that God does have a plan, with that. And my daughter's knowing that that's the way that I'm going to fight kind of gives me comfort to get through it.
I knew instantly I wanted to be a soldier in Rick's battle. Our first meeting included our families over dinner. We would become instantly bonded. Rick had videography experience through his work with Buck Commander, and I asked him if he would be willing to film me for an upcoming bow hunt for mule deer in the open plains of eastern Colorado. By the time the hunt became reality, we had spent a lot of time together and communicated daily. Rick had never hunted mule deer before, and his anticipation level was off the charts. Little did we know how fun this hunt would be and how special that buck would be that we were hunting. Rick has a way of not acknowledging his cancer and making people around him laugh. If you spend time with Rick, you will most certainly be laughing. It's deeply inspirational. As I picked him up at the airport, despite being one day post-chemo, our reunion was pure Rick Carone. We met up with Clint Pagnotta, a fantastic mule deer hunter, and in no time, we were looking at mule deer. Rick was beside himself with excitement.
We're contemplating a sneak right now. Our guide thinks he saw a nice antlered spike.
The little 13-year-old boy in Rick Carone pops up from time to time, and he got sidetracked with this porcupine.
Right.
Those things are pretty cool.
What do you think?
It did release some things out of its butt. Yeah. They didn't fly, but they kind of, they went.
They'll flare up. What do you think about porcupines?
Sharp quills.
But eventually things got serious. Suddenly, we spotted an enormous non-typical, and the mood became intense and focused. This was a buck we quickly named Beamer.
We just spotted this buck bedded down in this green draw. He's had some heavy captive.
After an initial failed stalk attempt due to shifting winds, we lost Beamer for several days. In the final minutes, on day 5 of the hunt, we found a large frame buck that we decided we would go for the next and final day of the hunt. It was a roller coaster of emotions. The buck we found was very nice, but we were connected to Beamer in an inexplicable way. The next morning, on the way to find the large frame typical, Clint locks up the brakes and we skid to a stop on the Snowy County Road. There were 6 deer standing about a half a mile away and one of them had a huge body. As the spotting scope came up, we quickly ID'd him as Beamer. The excitement level exploded. Within 2 hours, we had him bedded on a cut bank, made our approach, and waited for him to make his move. Suddenly, the wind swirled and the move became a frantic one. I completely lost all sense of the fact that Rick was filming and of my surroundings. The fact that I looked like Cat in the Hat just added to it.
Oh, I just shot Beamer.
Congrats.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. And I'm here with the most awesome person in the world, my cameraman and great friend on this trip. Cameraman on this trip, great friend forever, is Rick Carone.
This is the best part of a hunt, besides the pursuit of amazing animals, to me, is getting to share it with people that you care about and people that you enjoy spending time with. That's critically important to me. And my buddy Rick Carone, this is special, man. It's special to get to do this with you.
Well, I'm just happy and excited, one, to be on a hunting trip with you as a brother, and two, that you had me come out and film the trip. You know, means a lot to me, and just to spend the fellowship with you, man.
It's been unbelievable. Awesome.
Thank you. This is what
I want to do. I want to hold them like that for the rest of the time.
that is just so impressive.
You know, he looked up at me and saw me and how I was so emotional. And I believe it was a day later, he said, Rick, you know, I know this is your first time out here. And now that you got a taste of it, I want to give that gift back to you. And you're going to come hunting with me next year in the Eastern Plains right here back in Eastern Colorado. And, you know, it was an emotional time. It was something where I prayed for health. I thanked and praised God for bringing Brian into my life, because this isn't something that Brian is just booking a hunt for me. Brian is wanting to go on a hunt with me and sharing that fellowship and brotherhood and give back to me the honor and glory that he's had in an animal like this.
In the months leading up to the hunt, we both highly anticipated for a year, Rick's health took a sharp turn. Chemotherapy, a multitude of prescriptions, and a less than positive CT scan in the summer of 2015 dampened our hopes and spirits. I never told Rick, but I was downright scared the hunt would not be possible. November came, and we were extremely excited, but Rick had lost nearly 30 pounds since summer. It didn't dampen his drive, he was committed. Our guide that year was Ty McFarlane. Like Clint, he was a master mule deer hunter, and we were lifelong friends after our first meal together.
Looks like a darn good deer.
He was heavy horn.
Yeah. Heavy. I mean, he stuck out. It was like, whoa.
Turned out to be a solid up-and-comer, and he passed. I could see the fire was lit.
Just not a lot of time like that we're looking for, especially only being here a few hours. It's a good sign though. We're gonna have to put the mule deer shift on the shelf here for a second because I spotted a monster whitetail buck and he's pushing 170, so
you can't look a gift horse in the mouth, and we're out here to deer hunt. My tag's good for whitetail or a mule deer, so we're gonna go ahead and look to put a spot in stock on a wily whitetail buck. Never spotted and stalked a whitetail. Rick and Ty slipped to within 35 yards of this bedded giant. The tall CRP deflected Rick's arrow, and that giant old buck found a new zip code to live in for a few days. Rick's excitement was building, but I could tell his strength after the long stalk and the long wait was not. This is the part of Rick's fight that he hides. He only wants people to see the fun-loving, inspirational Rick. Everyone tends to believe that he's doing great all the time because he's such a warrior. The reality is, he fights privately like no other. For the next 3 days, Rick was barely able to get out of bed, and we were struggling to turn up a mature buck. Then, something happened. Rick found his second win, and we found a buck, an ancient, nearly toothless buck with an attitude, just the kind of buck Rick had hoped for.
Gotcha. Spotted literally two shooter mule deer. We absolutely have to close the distance this hunt right here, right now, because we have a 100% blizzard coming in. It's in the 50s right now, and wind just started picking up. But believe it or not, this is going to be blizzard 5 to 8 inches covered in snow and with about 35 mile an hour winds tomorrow, and I fly out the next day. So it's do or die time. We're going to do a stalk on our last afternoon here. Got one of the best in the business here, and we're going to try to close the distance. He's got a decoy just in case because we're rolling sagebrush and yucca. But we've got these deer bedded and two mature mule deer bucks, which I've never shot one before, so I'm excited.
Set management, face of plains. Sage Fest 2015. As I watched from the spotting scope, I couldn't believe the progress they were making. This buck was totally duped, right up until Rick dropped the string on him. Just as the buck went down, a wicked storm blew in. The hunt seemed to come together brilliantly and against all odds. For those celebratory moments, the world wasn't about cancer or fatigue or pain or worry. It was about happiness, brotherhood, accomplishment, and success. What seemed improbable was reality, and it felt great.
I cannot believe this. Ryan, this is the fifth day of our hunt, for my first ever hunt here in the Eastern Plains. Ty McFarland, you know, world-class guide. We went on so many stalks and finally came upon this guy. The morale was getting down, my health was getting down a little bit, mentally, physically, just toast. As you can hear in the background, we got major thunderstorms coming in, and this is just the front of it. It's hailing, raining. Ty, get in here, man. Come on, this is you.
This is you, brother.
Fork brow time.
Absolutely, dude. Unbelievable characteristics, and crawled through cactus and sagebrush, and unbelievable mule deer. I mean, look at the characteristics of this. Double brow here. I mean, kickers on each side, matching kickers, and he has double on this side. But you know,
good mass,
good mature representation, and this is what I wanted to get when I came here and I filmed you, Brian, last year. You know, we were blessed to kill Beamer, and we saw so many deer, and you gave me the opportunity of a lifetime here. My first ever mule deer. Woo!
Oh, you're gonna,
man.
Oh, look at the character.
Unbelievable, unbelievable character for, I mean, he's a monarch to me. I don't care what anyone else says. This is an absolute beast of a mature mule deer, and he's something that I'll never forget. Man, oh man.
Although Rick had to leave, my hunt would continue. I had a whitetail tag and we were determined to pursue the beautiful buck Rick had nearly taken. For the remainder of the archery season, we had close encounters with him. After archery season ended, we resumed our efforts as the rifle season opened a few days later. I've never worked harder for a deer than that. In a beautiful way, this amazing buck connected Rick and I once again. We were both very fortunate to have pursued and shared close encounters with a giant of the plains.
Oh, we got him, dude.
We got that son of a gun.
Oh!
19 days we've hunted this buck. I don't know how big that deer is. What I do know is I don't care. That deer is one of the very most special deer that I've ever hunted.
Is this Ricky Bobby?
I'm about to get on a fire engine for a parade with my family and the Team Carone Foundation deal.
Oh, no big deal. We just shot a monster buck. It's no big deal.
Yes! Yes! Awesome. You got him down. Unreal.
We're still 100 yards from the deer. We haven't even walked up to him.
Dude, I love you, man. I'm so excited beyond belief.
I've been having to kind of choke back some tears here before we walk up to that deer so I can talk. Are you seeing this? Oh, how beautiful is that? Oh.
I told Rick immediately, let's do it again next year. Despite a less than 10% chance of surviving that next year, Rick made a post on Facebook. In true Rick Carone fashion, he found a way to inspire others with his spirit. He posted an inspirational piece by Jocko Willink called Good. The video essentially encouraged you to look at each challenge of your life as an opportunity to conquer. As I watched the short video, I immediately experienced a mixture of tears and pure adrenaline-filled excitement. He wasn't going to let the bad news get him down. At that moment, I knew we were going to make that hunt together. We are back on the eastern plains of Colorado with Ty McFarlane, Ralph and Clint Pagnotta, and one of my very best friends, Chad Huddleston. A world-class group of guys. We all split up for our own hunts. Rick had a couple of beautiful stalks. We only had one cameraman, Ty Carey, who captured my incredibly long odds hunt in an epic way. We found a massive, dominant old buck in wide open country with over 20 other deer.
This is it. This is the moment. As hunters, always waiting for going in. Made a plan. We got a buck that's just running his face off right now.
I have so much respect for any animal that I hunt, but there's something about these prairie monsters. They live in this open country. Thank you, Lord. I am beyond grateful, and I could not mean that more sincerely. After we admired the buck, we called the guy so we could share that special moment in the field.
Solid nub.
Look at, this is what deer hunting is all about, getting to be with your buddies. At the scene, middle of the night in eastern Colorado, it doesn't get any better than this.
He's gonna look good next to me.
Yes.
The next day, the hunt got even better when we got a call that Rick had gotten a perfect arrow into a buck they were hunting called Captain Hook.
One of the most unbelievable hunting experiences I've ever had, brother.
Awesome,
love you,
bro.
Thank you.
Love you.
It was, dude, you have no idea.
No idea.
I can't wait
how
to
it,
put my hand
how
in.
It. How it.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
Oh, I'm still just beyond grateful, first of all,
yes.
To you and introducing me to this and taking me on hunts like this, Brian, is I'm speechless.
It's a pleasure, man.
And to be on, we killed Beamer together.
Yeah.
And then came out and
it's just like a 90 and a 90.
Yeah.
It's so wild.
And he's still carrying it.
Dude, like Cam says, it's all mental. It is.
It took all my strength to hold it together. Not one, but 2 years of goals and accomplishments realized. The best part is that each one of these guys realized the gravity of this situation. The fact that this was about way more than hunting mule deer. This hunt was particularly meaningful to me. I could see Rick's desire to, in his own words, just feel like a normal person. It pains me to hear people complain about day-to-day menial concerns when I reflect on the depth and worry and fear that plagues a person with a terminal diagnosis. It's incomprehensible. Understandably, most resort to daily sadness and tears, but a few special souls, like Rick Carone, choose to sing.
For the mountains, to the wide with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home, God bless America, my home sweet home.
It's Rick Carone, Master Hunter. Cross between Hunter and Adam Sandler, I think.
Mr. Stevens.
It's Canteen Boy right here.
Knocked my sunglass out with this cam.
Maybe Water Boy, I don't know.
Some high quality H2O.
Look at this.
What seems to be the problem there, Rick?
Mr. Stevens farted and it smells. So, I'm
cover up my scent nodules with this bag of nuts. Combination of the snacks and the mating calls of the gopher warbler.
The outdoors is my church, and I think of a scripture that I've shared with Brian quite a few times, and that's Luke 6:38, give and it will be given back to you. You know, give what you can. You don't have to have deep pockets and have a lot of money. Just give of your time, give of anything you have, and sure enough, it'll give you a feeling that you've never experienced before. And you can be sure that in some way, in some time, maybe not in your time, but you're gonna get gifted back as well.